This is Rosa Kelly, and today we're gonna decorate a mini album. And I'm gonna start with the cover. And as you know, I made a tutorial for how I made this mini album, and this is just a blank canvas mini album, so you can actually decorate it with any theme that you want. And I will put the link below if you haven't seen this tutorial yet. But for to decorate my album, I picked this Prima Saint-Tropez paper pad, and I really love the colors, the navy blue and the beach theme. It's just refreshing and fun. And then to complement my paper, I picked up these flowers from Michaels, and I love the colors. I think they go really good, and navy blue and grays. And then also I picked up these Prima flowers to give her a touch of pink. And then also I like the baby blue. And these ones I got at Hobby Lobby. And then I will also be using some burlap mats. And then I saw these on Michaels and I thought it went really good with this collection. So I'm gonna try to use these stamps right here. And then from my stash, I'm gonna be trying to incorporate some burlap flowers, and you know, just have fun, try to see what do you have. I have some of these ones also from Recollections, and then I have some of these ones that are also kind of blue, and I think they go really good, but we'll see what I use. I don't really have a plan what I'm gonna be doing, so we're going to do this together. So let's get started. So like I said, I don't really have a plan. All I know is I'm gonna use this paper collection, and I want the mini album to feel, you know, like earthy and kind of shabby, not really shabby, probably just like fresh and earthy. And so I'm grabbing one of my sparkle things just to keep this flat and even. So let's pick, what do we want to use for the cover? And I kind of looked at this already, but I'm still not really sure of what I like. Like I said, I want a lot of texture. So maybe I'm gonna be using this one for the front, and maybe I can layer a couple of papers. And I hope I have enough paper to complete this whole mini album. I love this page as well. So let's see. And then there's this very beautiful wood page that I really liked. So I think I'm gonna be using these three sheets for my cover. And then I saw this that says "I love you to the beach and back." And I definitely want that to be the title of my album. So I'm gonna use this page and, you know, fussy cut that out. So let's start by measuring the cover. I don't quite remember the size of my cover. So the cover measures 6 3/4 by 7 3/4. So I'm gonna be cutting the piece of paper for my cover at 6 1/2 by 7 1/2. So I'm gonna use this one right here. And I want my anchors, if you can see, there's some anchors there. I want those to be right side up. So I'm gonna cut 7 1/2 first. And then I will do 6 1/2, just like that. Now, I don't have a distressing tool, but I do want that distressed look. So I'm just gonna grab my scissors, just any pair of scissors that you have, and I'm just gonna start ripping the edge a little bit so the paper is not flat. I don't want my paper to be flat. So I distress my edge, and I'm gonna put this paper on the side, and then I wanna use this other beautiful design. Well, I like both sides, but I'm gonna use this one, and I'm just gonna cut a piece of 4x6. So I'm gonna cut this at 4, and I'm gonna cut it at 6. And I kind of want to layer this right here. And maybe I want to use the other side as well. So I'm just going to cut this right here, maybe at 4.5. I'm just kind of guessing right now. And maybe I will do like a 6. Okay, so I'm gonna go ahead and distress the edge again, just like I did before. All right, so I have my distress edges, and what I think I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna just layer them kind of like this. Maybe I'll make this one a little bit shorter. Yeah, just like that. Oops. And let me distress this. Like I said, I don't really have a plan. I'm just having fun right now. And some of you requested to see kind of like a process of how I do my albums. So that's exactly what I'm doing. Like, sometimes it takes me longer to figure out what I want to do. Sometimes I really have a plan, you know. So I think I like how this is looking. I'm not gonna glue it yet because I do tend to change my mind a lot. So I was just looking through my stuff, and I remember I had this little seahorse. So I think I wanna use this little guy. So cute and very sparkly too. So I wanna see how I can incorporate this. And then I also found this, so I think I'm gonna try to use this as well. I like the pearls, and of course there's pearls on the sea, so I think that can also work. So I'm gonna grab my little sentiment here that I wanna use, and I'm just gonna fuzzy cut it out. So I can start playing around with it and seeing if, you know, how can I put it on the page. Whoops. Okay, so here it is. And also I'm going to give it a rough edge here with my scissors. I always tell my girls, I love you to the moon and back. So this is kind of cute. This is, I love you to the beach and back. I love it. So I'm just gonna try to break it and make it look distressed and a little bit like old and, you know, kind of like the things that are around the beach. They'll rusted. So I'm kind of liking how this looks. I do want to put a picture here of my girls at the beach, so I'm not gonna be embellishing a lot around this area, but I think I'm gonna do like a flower cluster around the other side. So before I glue anything, I like to layer my items to see how it would look, you know, like maybe I like it, maybe I don't. But right now we are just playing around. I wish I was live so you can tell me what you think. But it's a little bit late here. It's really late in the evening. So I think I'm going to push this up and push this down. And I'm just gonna play around with this a little bit. And I don't know if I want to put the seahorse on this page, or maybe add it as a charm on the spine. I'm not sure yet. Let's see. I'm trying not to make this video too long because then I will have problems uploading it. The other day I was uploading a video when I was doing a different tutorial and it was over an hour long, so I couldn't upload it, and I had already erased it off my phone, so I couldn't combine it, and it was a big mess. Oh, I like this little guy. Okay, so let me play around with this a little bit and I'll be right back. So I added this little Prima flower right there just to give it a touch of pink and color, and I think I like how this looks already. It doesn't have to be difficult. You don't have to struggle with this for hours. I think just like this will, I love it. I really think I like it. So I'm gonna take a picture of this there, and I'm going to move this. I take a picture so I remember what I did. And maybe I'll end up doing something else, but that's the plan. So I'm gonna start gluing my layers of paper, and before I start gluing my flowers and embellishments, I'm gonna cover the back side as well. So this is number one. Okay, and then let me see here. I'm just gonna put this one on top of this one, and then I'm gonna glue this one. So just like that. So I'm gonna cut another piece of, I'm gonna put this on the side, and I'm gonna cut another piece of 6.5 by 7.5 for my back cover, and I'm gonna use this paper because I really like it. Let me think. I'm kind of having second thoughts. Okay, I am gonna change my mind. I think I'm gonna use this paper for the back. Because I feel like this, even though I love it, it contrasts too much from my cover, and I don't know. Okay, so I'm just gonna cut another piece, like I said, of 7.5 by 6.5. So this is 7.5 and 6.5, and I'm gonna distress the edge one more time, and then I'm gonna glue this piece on my back. Okay, so I have my edges all distressed. Ooh, this one's pretty too. I like this one too. But I'm just gonna stick to this side because it is the ocean after all. So this is the ocean right here. Okay, so let's go ahead and glue it. And note that I'm not really gluing right along the edge because I want my edges to come out a little bit. So I'm just gonna place. And here we go. So now we can go back to decorating our cover. So I think I remember what I did. I hope I'm remembering. How cute is this butterfly? Oh, it's this way. Okay, so it was something like this and something like that, and like this. I'm gonna put this one first because I want to make sure I don't cover my title. So I'm just gonna put this one right here, maybe a little bit off You know, that's all it is when you're scrapbooking, is just having fun. You know, you kind of play around with what you want to do. I never really have a plan other than the kind of paper I want to use, or, you know, the theme of the album. But I think I really have fun just playing with it, with everything. Look, I'm looking for my tape. Okay, got it. Okay, so I'm just gonna just secure it with my tape here, double-sided tape, and then I'm gonna cover it with the flower anyway, so. Oh, my nails don't really help. Okay, so, and then I think I was gonna do something like this. Ooh. Okay, so when I add my flowers on the cover, I always use fabric tag. It's a little bit stronger. It will hold everything a lot better. So I'm just gonna add this one here, and then, oh, this one's already glued in, but okay, so then we're gonna put that one there. Okay, my butterfly in the corner. So cute. Okay, and then let's see, my seahorse. I think I want my seahorse right here, but I'm only gonna glue the bottom of him because I'm probably gonna put a picture right under him. So place this guy right here. Okay, and then last but not least, my little flower for a touch of pink. There you go. So it's very simple, but I think it's very cute, and the picture, to me, is gonna make the best embellishment. I love this right here. This is "I love you to the moon, to the beach and back." So cute. I think I really love this butterfly, but I think she needs a haircut. Okay. So, I don't know. I really like it. I like it. And then I like the back. It's simple. It's the beach. And then for my spine, I'm not sure yet what I'm going to do. But I think I really want to use a burlap piece. I don't think if this burlap is long enough. I think my album is a little bit bigger, but let's see what we come out with. Okay, so I'm gonna put my album like this now, and I know this is not long enough, but that's okay. Okay, I don't think I cut this very straight, but that's okay. It gives it character, you know. Ooh, this. yeah, I kind of like it. And then I can use these and just piece it. So I think I have to cut it right there. You can't really tell. Can you tell? Maybe a little bit. It's okay, it's just for my kids. Let me do this. But then I'm gonna embellish with a cute flower, so I can't tell. Okay, so I'm just gonna glue this in because I think I like it. I really don't like overthinking my mini albums. I think things come out better when you don't have a set plan, because if you have a set plan and it doesn't go the way you want it, then you don't like it anymore. So that's how I see my albums, that's how I see life. Okay, so I'm going to try to make this seamless. A little bit crooked. And then I'm gonna put my flower. Okay. I love this flower, it's so cute. And there you go. There's my spine. So we have our front, our spine, our back, and I'm gonna stop right here for today because it's really, really late and I have to work tomorrow. So I hope you guys like my cover tutorial, and I will be back with the pages probably tomorrow or so. Thank you all for watching. Bye bye.